Hello everyone, I'm Anuj Jaggi and I'm a legal intern with Access & Company, and the topic for today's video presentation is regulation of trade union. So the history of trade unionism in India can be traced back to the early 1890s, where the first time an association of mill workers was formed. It was established under the presidentship of Mr. N.H. Lokhande, who was the father of the trade unionism and editor of the famously weekly Dinabandhu. So the declaration of war in 1914 has helped the growth of trade union movement. The entire economic situation was changed during that period of time. High cost of living, wages, there were high cost of living and the wages were comparatively very low. So there was a series of strikes which improved their conditions. However, they needed proper guidance and leadership. So the Russian Revolution and formation of industrial labor organization were influential, and the Madras Labor Union was the first type in India, which is in 1918. So by 1920, a large number of trade unions were being formed. In 1920, AITUC formed with was the first trade union which was being centrally formed by the trade unions, which was the first kind of the trade union. So in 1926, the Indian Trade Union Act from criminal and civil the Indian Trade Union Act was passed, which legalizes trade unions and protects the trade unions from criminal and civil liabilities. The Trade Union Act 1926 has been repealed by the Industrial Relations Code of 2020. So, the concept of trade union is that the trade union is a group of workmen who have grouped themselves in an organization to secure various benefits. However, the activities of trade unions these days are not confined to the securing the economic benefits. It includes welfare activities, environmental conditions, and other beneficiaries also. These are voluntary organizations promote their social economic benefits by collective actions. The various well-known central trade union organizations in India are, for example, All India Trade Union Congress, the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, Center of Indian Trade Unions, Hind Mazdoor Sabha, Indian Federation of Free Trade Unions, etc. So, Section 28 of the Industrial Relations Code of 2020, which provides for recognition of trade unions at central and state level. When the central or the state government is of the opinion that it is necessary that a trade union or federation of trade unions is to be recognized as a central trade union at the central level, it may recognize such trade unions for or federations of trade unions as central trade union in such manner and for such purposes only. And the various this was the various kinds of trade unions and their purposes. Now the aim and objective of forming a trade union is that the passing of Indian Trade Unions Act of 1926 was an important landmark in the history of the trade unions movement in the country. So in addition to giving a legal status to the registered trade unions, the registration conferred on trade union and their members a measure of immunity from civil suits and criminal proceedings. The act has basically two main objectives under this. Its first objective was to relieve all trade unions from civil and criminal liabilities, which is to grant immunity. Second one was to provide for a system of voluntary registration of trade unions requiring the adoption of adequate rules, the keeping and adequate of proper amounts and filling of annual re-returns. So the act extends to the whole of India, and the IR code which has repealed the act has the same purposes with respect to the regulation of trade unions. It has not made any major change in provisions. So further, the various features or characteristics of trade union are that it always acts through united actions of members, that is collectively. Second is, it is voluntary organizations of workers. And next is, it protects the economic interests and make efforts to the welfare of the workers. And further, it is concerned with economic, political, social, cultural cultural life of the members. Moreover, it includes federation of trade unions also, and its role is similar to that of mediators within an organization, though it is primarily meant for protection of interests of its members, but it also plays the role of intermediary between labor and management. So this was the concept of a regulation of trade unions, and I hope I was able to give you guys a clear picture about it, and thank you.